وبعد، قال تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت، والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله الأماني، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected brothers, elders, mothers, sisters, and youngsters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We commence by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator and sustainer, and we send the choicest blessings upon the final messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace and blessings upon him. It is the nature of the human being, or the temperament of the human being, that the human being always strives for success, for good. And it's the nature of man and humanity that we try to avoid failure. We avoid loss, and we don't want to get into any form of harm. Allah Most High mentions this in the Quran, لَا يَسْأَمُ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ دُعَاءِ الْخَيْرِ, that the human being is never satisfied from seeking good. The human being's nature is that we always want good. So whether it's a product that we are purchasing, or whether it's whether we need to take time off of school or work, or it may be venturing into a business deal, we analyze the situation, we examine the conditions, and if we feel there is benefit for us, we move forward. We purchase the product, we make the deal, we take the time off. However, if through our assessment and our examination, we've made a decision that this is harmful, this is not of benefit for us, then we don't move forward. We decline, we reject the deal. So this is in terms of our worldly success, our material success. The very same actions that we undertake for our worldly success, we need to analyze a step further. And that's what I want to talk about today. And this analyzing or this examining is to place the awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while we are examining the situation. That this action that I am about to undertake, this deal that I'm about to make, or this commitment that I am standing up to, is it pleasing to the Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or is it not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And this trait is generally known as muhasaba. According to Islamic terminology, comes from the word hisab. Literally, hisab means to count. What it actually means, a near translation in the English language, would be introspection, to self-evaluate, to examine, muhasaba. So the ulama, they explain the concept of muhasaba, of examining, self-evaluation, and introspection. And they point out many benefits for muhasaba, for evaluation. This particular trait will at least give two benefits to the human being, to the believer. One is that when we engage in muhasaba and evaluation, self-assessment, then it will make us more thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second benefit is that when we self-evaluate, when we engage in muhasaba, we will refrain from loss, from harm, from injustice and sin. So when we engage in muhasaba, we will be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An example can be given. Many of us, some of us, may already be contemplating that I want to purchase the new iPhone. While we are contemplating this, we should self-evaluate. Is there a need for it? We should self-evaluate. What are the benefits for me? And through the evaluation, this thought should also come in our minds that there are people in other parts of the world, human beings just like us, who don't have sufficient money to purchase a decent meal. They don't have water to drink. They don't have medicine to purchase that they can treat themselves. So when will this happen? When we self-evaluate, when we make muhasaba, when we look into ourselves, that is this really of benefit or not? I was speaking to a brother from Burma 2 weeks ago, and he was telling me the description of what actually is happening in Burma. And subhanAllah, he was saying that the Rohingya Muslims, they're not even allowed to marry. According to the law, they're not permitted to get married. They're not allowed to have businesses. They don't allow them to leave their villages and their towns. And in the towns, they're creating massacre and murders. So they're basically, they have no concept of life. They're unable to live. So when we hear about these situations, immediately the believer has two responsibilities. Number one is we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has protected us from such a situation. And number two is we need to pray and support for those people who are suffering. May Allah be with them. And may Allah allow us to aid and support wherever we can those people who suffer. So when will we get these thoughts? When will this cross our mind? When we engage in muhasabah, when we introspect and we examine ourselves and the situations around us. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Khalifatul Muslimin, the leader of the Muslims, when he would go into any difficulty in this worldly life, he would smile. And he would say that every difficulty that I go through, it has three blessings. It has three bounties, three ni'mas, three blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So someone asked Umar ibn al-Khattab, if you go through a difficulty, for example, you lost your camel. Umar ibn al-Khattab loses his camel. It strays away. He doesn't know where it is. So now, people asked him, what three blessings do you see in your difficulty? You've lost your commodity. You've lost your asset. So he responded by saying, the three bounties that I see in every difficulty, number one is that I thank Allah that He didn't take away my faith, my iman. This is the greatest blessing of Allah. I lost my camel, I didn't lose my faith. So I thank Allah that He didn't bring the difficulty on my deen. It was on my dunya. Number two, I self-evaluate, I assess the situation and I tell myself that I've only lost my camel, this is the difficulty, but it could have been worse. There are people who suffer far more than me. So I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I've only lost my camel, it could have been far worse. I could have lost a limb. I could have ended up in an accident. There could have been something that is very tragic that would happen and it would cause me tremendous pain. So this is the second bounty I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for in any difficulty. And the third is, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ring in my ears. Where the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, says that when a believer is patient on any difficulty of this world, then there is ajr, there is reward, there is bounty and blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَتَّى الشَّوْكَةُ يُشَاكُهَا. To the extent that even if a thorn pricks the believer, a thorn pricks the believer, that is also rewarding in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in a difficulty, Umar ibn al-Khattab is analyzing, is making muhasabah, is introspecting, and he's seeing benefits and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the benefits of introspection and muhasabah, is that we will become grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what we have. And I mentioned that the second benefit is that it'll help us refrain and abstain from injustice, from doing wrong. I was reading an article earlier on about debt. This article was pointing out that 70% of Canadians are in debts. And the article is breaking up the situation into different categories. And one section of the article is saying that many Canadians who are in debts, they are in unnecessary debts. Why? Because they're spending where they should not be spending. It's people are spending for luxuries that are not really a need. It's not really required in their life. So careless spending. And they're pointing out that if these Canadians stop spending carelessly and they budget and they look carefully, they analyze their situations, then they will find themselves getting out of their debts very quickly. So the point is that if we spend carelessly, if we don't budget, if we don't look at our situations, if we don't look at the situation of the markets and the economy, and we spend carelessly, we're not analyzing our situation, we're not making muhasaba, then it's creating a harm for ourselves in this world. Similarly, if we don't make muhasaba of our actions, we don't introspect, we don't evaluate, assess, and examine our actions, then they might end up taking us towards the wrath and the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if we evaluate and we make muhasaba, these actions will take us near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will save ourselves from a lot of harm. We'll save ourselves from a lot of distress, both in this world and also in the everlasting life of the hereafter. The verse of the Quran where Allah reminds us about these kind of things. فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Two things Allah is talking about in this verse. The one who fears standing before Allah. What is this? This is muhasaba, introspection. If we always bring forward before us that one day I will have to stand before Allah. So the one who fears standing before Allah, number one. Number two, وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. And a person abstains from following their desires and their temptations, especially when they're contrary to the teachings of Allah. Then Allah says, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Then paradise is theirs. They own paradise. So what are these two qualities? These two qualities are connected to muhasaba. They're connected to self-evaluation and looking into oneself. And when we have this concept, then not only will we benefit in this world, but also in the hereafter. So a person will not cheat to a client. I can maybe get away in this world, but if I have the awareness of Allah that I have to stand before Him, then I will make sure that I don't cheat. It'll motivate me that I will be questioned. A young brother told me, you know, he was at a store and he purchased an expensive product. And a number of dollars were returned to him, and it was an error. So he said, I felt like taking the money. But then I went back. So I asked him, why did you go back? Why did you give the money back? So he said, I remember that the day of judgment, Allah will question me. Allah will ask me on the day of judgment. So I might escape in this world, but I cannot escape in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is muhasaba. This is self-evaluation. This is introspection. So when we introspect, we save ourselves from harm of this world and also the harm of the hereafter or the difficulties of the hereafter. So the plan of action is that we need to evaluate. We need to pause and reflect. We need to think that by saying this, will it cause some negative aspects in my life or will it bring positive? لا يسأم الإنسان من دعاء الخير. I started off with this verse that the believer, the human being is never satisfied, is always seeking good. So we should also seek the good, not only of this world, but also in terms of our betterment in the hereafter and our position before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why again, Umar ibn al-Khattab, from his life we find tremendous examples. One of his very famous statements is, حاسبوا قبل أن تحاسبوا. حاسبوا أنفسكم. Evaluate yourselves, take a stock of yourselves. Before your stock is taken, before the hisab is taken. And then he says, وَزِنُوا أَعْمَالَكُمْ. Weigh your own deeds. Weigh your own deeds before the deeds are weighed on the day of judgment. So what is this? This is muhasaba. This is self-evaluation that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu is talking about. So I was yesterday at a interfaith event that was also organized by the Islamic Foundation of Toronto. And we need to know about these things, by the way. You know, the Scarborough General Hospital generally holds certain events during the year. And one of these events is that where cultural or ethnic backgrounds or religious groups, they come in, they're given a platform, and they interact with the staff of the Scarborough General Hospital. And with this interaction, it creates a sense of community. So in collaboration with the Islamic Foundation of Toronto, yesterday there was an event that took place similar to this, and it was an Eid celebration. So I was asked to speak a few words on Eid and Ramadan, etc. And I knew that majority of the people there, what was in their minds is the film and all those protests. So I deliberately touched upon the topic, and it was an interactive session, and we see the sentiments of people, and what they're saying is exactly what we were mentioning last week in the khutbah, that people are saying that, is this Islam? Why does, when Muhammad's name is taken, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in a negative way, in an inappropriate way, why do people become so emotional? To the extent that it takes away life, people are dying because of this? This is what they are questioning. So exactly what I said last week. They don't understand the concept, but they're looking at the emotions and the image. And one brother just told me before I came that, are you mentioning anything about the cartoons? The French magazine, some of you probably heard, they published some cartoons, derogatory and offensive to the Muslims. So this is going to continue. But what is our sentiment and how do we approach this? So I addressed the matter and I said, no doubt that it's wrong, it's emotional. And I gave some examples. I gave some examples from their own communities. For example, the pastor in the United States who said, burn all the Qur'ans. I said, I wouldn't consider that as Christianity. I would consider that his own actions. Okay, and anyone that's associated with him, similar type of action, I would not consider that as Christianity. Because I know I've read about Christianity. I know what Christianity is. But how many of you have read about Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him? How many of you know where he was born? And then I mentioned that the same sentiments we have for Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, that's the same sentiments that I have and Muslims have for Jesus and Moses, for Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and also Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. If someone would create a negative image of Jesus, we would have the same emotions in our hearts. Yes, there are bad apples everywhere. People take their emotions to a level where they forget about what justice is. And they end up doing things that are inappropriate and wrong. And I gave reference to my sermon that I gave last week, that I've told my community, I told my congregation, that how did the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, respond? He responded with calmness. And he showed character, he showed morals, and this is what attracted people to Islam and to the teachings of the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him. So we need to reiterate that we don't get emotional. Let people say what they want to say. Let's not concentrate on the negative. Let us concentrate on the positive. Tell your friends and your non-Muslim neighbors about Islam, about Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him. Give them a good book about the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, as a gift, that people are talking about the Prophet Muhammad. Here's a book that answers 100 questions about the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him. This is a positive way to respond. So when will this happen? When we self-evaluate. Another point that I mentioned to them is that we need to look at hate as hate. We need to look at oppression as oppression. Whether it's a person in the Middle East or in a cave of Afghanistan that's doing something that is considered terrorism or wrong, we should say and call that as wrong and an oppression. And whether it's a person that's sitting in the White House, or whether it's a person who's in a suit and tie in a conference in the western part of the world who's saying a statement of hate, we gotta consider that as hate and oppression. And we can't let hate rule the world. Our voices, we are good people. We are decent people. We are people of faith. We are people of justice. What we need to do is we need to work together to remove the voices of hate and bring about the voices of goodness. And when can this happen? When we analyze ourselves. A beautiful article written by Harun Siddiqui in the Toronto Star last week. Some of you probably read it. And what's the title of his article? Moderates in the West need to raise their voices. There are people of sanctity. There are people of justice. They know what's right and wrong. They need to raise their voices. That hate is hate everywhere. We don't offend any religion. Freedom of expression is not that we insult someone. Freedom of expression is that we give our opinion. I gave my opinion that I don't worship Jesus. I respect Jesus, but I don't worship him. That's my opinion. But I don't say anything wrong about an idol that someone may be worshiping. Yes, I don't worship the idol, but I don't insult. لَا تَسُبُّ الْ I was just looking at the verse before I came and some of the books of tafsir. Allah says in the Quran, لَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ What does Allah say here? Do not insult those people who worship other than God, other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Fakhruddin al-Razi writes, what we learn from this verse is, we should not behave or act or even do anything that would bring people further away from Islam. That's what Allah is teaching us. So by becoming emotional, by doing wrong things, is it furthering us people away from Islam, or is it bringing people to Islam? We need to ask this question. When can we do this? When we analyze, when we make muhasaba. Every word of ours, every action of ours in our daily lives, with our families, with our co-workers, with our employees or employers, we need to look into ourselves. That what am I doing, is it pleasing to Allah or is it not pleasing to Allah? Is it just or is it unjust? When we analyze ourselves and we make muhasaba, we will see ourselves getting closer towards good and abstaining from harm and injustice. And at the same time, it'll motivate us to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the ability to always remain just. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to understand muhasaba, self-evaluation. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all forms of harm. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to always increase in our good. And may Allah give us all the success of this world and the everlasting life of the year after. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.